the time when the global team from Amazon approached us and said, why don't you give this a shot? This was in 2017 sometime, and we said, why not? You know, there is no harm in trying it out. All it took was a few minutes of setup, a little bit of photo shoots, uploading the products online, and literally a try karte hain kind of strategy happened to work for us, and it became a big success story for us.
That we often say technology has democratized the business opportunity for business is a false size. What is the significance of this level playing field, especially for entrepreneurs and startups?
All the traditional hurdles which would have been there for any new startup or business have now gone away.
I think understanding the market and the consumer is a universal truth. So whether you go to the US, you go to Europe, you go to Middle East, you go to any part of the world, you can't just say, I'm going to put a product out there, it'll sell. So even though infrastructure is there, capital is there, you still need to do your research. So to me, the first order of priority that any small company should have is to figure out, you know, what is it that I am trying to do and what is my offering to that particular consumer in that market.
Right. I think for companies that are launching, global first, once they sort of identify the market, they all do all the research. Once you launch a product, I do think it's very important to get product market fit, right?
You spoke about how you got started, but when you think about the global customer today, do you think they're more receptive towards Made in India as a brand, and how do you really perceive it?
My design team, now we work mostly on gender neutral products. If I'm designing a product, I'm not going to think of a girl doing that. I'm going to think of a girl and a boy both working on that. And